How much would it cost for a hair transplant? I have a receding hairline. How much would it cost for a hair transplant if I wanted to lower my hairline?
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a single photo and you've asked one question: how much for a hair transplant? And with that question, you also state you have a receding hairline. Well, the question you're asking really has a lot of dimension. And it is natural for you to ask about cost of a hair transplant, because it's most likely that as you've been doing research for your hair loss issue, you've come across hair transplant as the majority or dominant resource or answer for hair loss. But I'm going to help you understand a little bit more in the context of your situation. You stated you have a receding hairline. That means this is an ongoing process. So think about what will happen after you have a hair transplant. You can certainly shop around and you can find different doctors to offer you a transplant. But what happens as your hairline recedes? You may not know the rate in which the hair is receding. You don't know how far and how fast this process is going to go. And the very important thing to understand is you can't continue transplanting your hair. And unfortunately, that limitation has led to a lot of people being stuck at certain key points and actually needing to have more transplantation surgery. So, in addition, I would also add a comment. With African American skin, or people of African descent who wear short hairstyles, as it appears you do from your submitted photo, the donor area, which is in the back in that permanent zone where you never lose hair, the scars that you can potentially have, regardless of the technique, whether it's FUE or follicular unit extraction, or FUT or follicular unit transplant, can result in undesirable scars. So I'll let you know what we do in our practice. We have been in a remarkable position because we've developed an option to help people with hair thinning. And before going into that, let me just discuss with you first, what are your medical options? Because first you have to work on some type of strategy to stabilize the progression of your hair loss. Again, you have to think of the future. As much as it may be satisfying to just get a transplant and look good in a year or so after the transplant, what happens 4 or 5 years and beyond down the line is critical. There are two drugs that are currently FDA approved in the United States for hair loss. One is finasteride, which is a pill that you take daily, and the other is minoxidil, which is a topical that you apply daily. Now, finasteride works by inhibiting an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. This is an enzyme in your body that converts testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. And when you do your research about hair loss, you hear about dihydrotestosterone, or DHT, a lot. Now, the only systemic way of reducing it is by taking a medication. The problem we're having with trying to prescribe this medication this time is nobody wants to take it because of concerns of long-term sexual side effects even after stopping taking the drug. So in our practice, what we've developed and have been very successful with is a treatment called hair regeneration. Hair regeneration is, from my perspective, a real change in the approach to the treatment of hair loss that is an alternative to medications, which have to be taken daily and has variable levels of success, and surgery. Hair regeneration is a treatment which involves an injection. And it's an injection of a material called extracellular matrix and combined with platelet-rich plasma. Many people confuse platelet-rich plasma as a standalone treatment when they compare it with our treatment. From my experience, and I think most of my colleagues would agree, platelet-rich plasma does not stop hair thinning on its own. We use it as a way to enhance the process but the key to our treatment is the extracellular matrix. This is a wound healing material that has remarkable abilities that I use every day, because I also, in addition to hair loss, I do full body cosmetic surgery. So we've been able to use this material to create some wonderful wound healing results. We've helped regrow cartilage outside of the body for a man who had lost part of his ear from melanoma. So there really are remarkable things, and I think it represents the next level of medical care, which is involving stem cell therapy. Unfortunately, stem cell therapy is very controversial because of a lot of the misinformation. This is the adult stem cells that already live in your body that are recruited as part of wound healing. So essentially, we've been able to treat close to 100% of patients who come to us with male pattern hair loss and get significant results, which I would say in the majority of patients, depending again on the time that they come, exceeds the results of hair transplant surgery. Timing is important, so the earlier we catch someone, the better it is for them. So if someone wanted hair transplant surgery and they have an area that has thinning hair or receding hair, then we actually treat first with hair regeneration, wait the 12 to 18 months to see what kind of result we get before even discussing hair transplant surgery. It's very important that you have stabilization. The challenge that we see constantly, and the more we're known and the people come to us from all over the world for hair regeneration treatment, we see so many people who contact us and are desperate because they had a hair transplant 5 to 10 years ago and they look very pluggy. They look like they have hair plugs. And the reason is that the existing hair that was there at the time disappeared, and the patient only has the hair grafts. And then they look at their donor area, and you know they actually will have less donor available for further transplantation. It becomes a zero-sum game because in the end, you tap out your limited donor area. So with that being said, learn more about your alternative options. You may want to consider trying medical therapy first. You may want to consider doing hair regeneration as an option as well. But it's very important that you don't just chase the receding hairline, because eventually you cannot match the amount of loss with the amount of hair that's available in your donor. And this is why we're so excited about the benefits of hair regeneration, because nature already has the hairs very close together. This hair thinning becomes hair that's thicker, results in so much more volume and coverage that it really is remarkable what we've been able to accomplish. So with that being said, I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.